Welcome to a very special edition of Size Eyes in the Skies. We've got our final show for those of us seniors graduating today. We'll make sure to bring you some information about the weather coming here. We'll also show some of the memories we've had over the past couple of years with all of us here at Size Eyes. Please stay tuned for this great show.
Oh man, I wanted to throw my hand in there.
I'm gonna give you some mic room.
Oh yeah, if you cut my mic out.
I'm not!
ISU TV's longest running television show brings you the weather around the country, in Iowa, Ames, and beyond. The Iowa State Meteorology Department's team of forecasters keeps you ahead of the next weather system. Size Eyes on the Skies starts now.
Okay, well, can't believe this day has finally come.
It's so true. This is our last show for all of us on the show tonight. Nick graduating, Tyler graduating, I'm graduating, Curtis, who's over there, we'll talk to him in a little bit. He's also graduating.
We've also got Liz over there on the computer. She might show up at some point tonight, we'll see.
Yeah, so it's been a good run. It really has.
I have one too. Gotta make a call to Nick Kroll. He's down interning tonight, but if he was,
he's missing as well.
I'm sure he'd be there tonight with us.
Right, yeah.
What a surreal moment.
It really is.
I remember being here last year during the senior show, and I was like, oh, that, you know, whatever.
It'll come eventually.
I just even remember last semester we had two people that had been active in Size of the Graduate.
Yeah, like a half senior show.
It's
that was
like,
kind of fun.
You know, it's like, oh, yeah, that will happen someday. And it's like, it's already
today
come.
Today is that day. So yeah.
We didn't bring them on the show this time, though, Jeff and Matt. We didn't put pictures up. Wow. I kind of thought about decorating the back with like Myers, Gertz, all those guys.
Yeah, all those
wonderful
guys. Mr. Edmondson still got a couple of votes last night during our election. So his spirit is still being felt around here.
He's still very
present. His presence. His spirit makes him like he's dead. His presence is still around. My mistake.
All these people are alive and well,
yes.
Thank goodness. But
Very well.
I really am. I'm very, very speechless because I don't know how to take this.
Yeah, I don't really have any words right now. But maybe let's just start with a happy moment. Favorite memory of your 4 years or 3 years here at Size Eyes on the Skies.
I know this from the top of my head. We had a really awesome night, the Dead Week Blizzard. We came in here, did some live coverage. I remember I was sitting in the back, just pulling up information constantly. We were here for about?
Well, I think we were on air for a full hour.
About an hour. Nice. We had live measurements outside. We had our cars parked. We came out, and our cars were buried under like 8 inches of snow.
Sam Schreier, folks, did a terrific job with the ruler. I remember he kept going out there. He measured under a tree. He measured in a drift. He did a great job, though. I mean,
very thorough.
Yeah. Well, that was... You stole my memory. That was probably one too. That was one of our only like big special coverage shows that I've experienced here at Iowa State. So very exciting because we got to do live coverage outside, which is kind of like what we may do in the future.
Do reporting and such.
Yep, and it ran very smoothly. And even though it was very chaotic, very smooth. And it's something that I'm very proud of that we pulled it together, and it was awesome. It was a great experience.
So. It's really all about resume building. Yeah. And one episode I liked was a couple years ago when Justin Gertz came down, and it was like the American Idol themed show. And I remember we did an interview. Well, I think Matt Hoffman did the. He always gets a plug on here.
Right.
But anyway, so he did an interview with Justin Gertz. Right over there on our little talk show set, and that was pretty fun, and we all had different nicknames, and it was just a very, very chaotic show, very, very fun and entertaining, to say the least. But now there was a lot of entertaining memories, though.
We try to keep it professional, but we do have a lot of fun on this show here.
I mean, gotta make people enjoy it.
Those boards over there have gone through a lot. Ryan Ellis has been destructive. He's destroyed those. We've gone through quite a set change throughout the years.
We actually used to do our show over there. The desk was over there where the green screen is. So
yeah, before I
came. I guess if you could see the studio, you would know.
Yeah, the green screen right here.
Now we're over here, and we're actually up on risers, which are new this year. So
And it's a full floor.
Yeah.
It used to be just a little island.
We've seen a lot of changes there, but here.
We used to do completely different segments, and if you happen to know when that changed, you might have been an advantage with tonight's trivia question.
Ooh, yeah. So that'll be a good one. Maybe we should should ask. We should get Curtis on here. Maybe we should ask him about Iowa weather.
Yeah, we should. Let's. We bantered for a really long time here. We'll have much more to talk about at the end. But let's actually get back in focus. This is a weather show. So let's go over to Curtis and see what we have going on here.
Hi there. Speaking of fun and questions, though, I have a question for you. What is a Funnel Cloud's favorite game to play?
Oh, I have no idea. What is it?
Twister.
Oh.
Although we're looking at the clouds diminishing this evening, maybe even see a few stars and the moon tonight. But we're going to see those clouds move back into the area tomorrow and with some more rain chances. If we can go ahead and look at our daily planner, we can see that tonight, or around midnight, about 37 degrees, and into 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, about 35, a little bit cooler, with northeast winds from 5 to 10 miles per hour. At 3 p.m. tomorrow, we see those rain clouds going to move in and keep us around 48 degrees. With winds, of course, at the southeast, about 8 to 15 miles per hour. So we'll be a bit breezy tomorrow.
Okay, yeah, that sounds great.
Yeah.
So we'll see what's going on. And now let's go right back on over here, and I will be right back with some more fun after the break. Thanks for that. The British team with us over the break. Let's see what we got over with Tyler on the wall.
Oh, thank you very much, Nick. Oh, once again, surreal moment. I can't believe this is the final time to be in front of this wonderful green screen, but we'll bear with it and we'll get through tonight's show. We'll talk about some weather headlines out there. We did break, as of right now, you notice behind me, tentatively, there's a star, there's an asterisk. Tentatively, we did break the April tornado record. The old record was at 267, which was set back in 1974. And currently, if this verifies, so far, we're at 272. So we have another about 10 days left of the month to see what happens. And there could be some interesting outbreaks coming up in the next few days to keep an eye on. So that could certainly boost that tornado count. Snow in April. Portions of northern Iowa received some snow just the other day. But over in Wisconsin, 8 inches of snow reported in some locations. Hard to believe it was April 19th. And they're still getting a lot of snow. It's just been the little pattern we've been in that's been giving us very cold weather, unseasonably cooler than average temperatures. But on the bottom there, we will see a warm-up on the way, and we'll talk about that later in the show, of course. But until then, we'll talk about the convective outlook. This is what SPC down in Norman puts out. Down here in the south, this is today. This is the day one. There's a slight risk for severe weather down there. There's actually a bunch of severe thunderstorm watches down there at this moment, and there actually is another small risk up on the east coast as well. Heading into day two, it just doesn't stop. There's more outbreak potential down in Missouri, Oklahoma, Arkansas, portions of northeast Texas, another area to keep an eye on heading into tomorrow for some more potential severe weather. Wind, hail, primary threats. But day three, once again, it just does not quit. This time it extends a little bit farther to the north and east, Illinois, Indiana, portions of Kentucky and Tennessee, also getting in on some of this severe weather action. But let's take a look at Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. They'll be under the gun for tomorrow, 73. Good chance of severe weather heading into their area. Friday, though, gets pretty warm, 82 degrees. Don't know why there's snow on Saturday. So it's not going to be snowing in 77 down in Oklahoma. But it will warm up very nicely, as you see, by Monday, 80 degrees. And very comfortable weather for those folks down in Oklahoma City. But now let's take you up to the far northeast, up in Clayton Lake, Maine, where they're going to see a lot of snow. Actually, they're going to see a great deal of snow. They're under a winter storm warning right now. Could see quite a bit of snow in terms of accumulations. Now this sun, obviously 41 is not very warm, but they're going to see the sun for the first time in at least the next 5 days, because heading into Saturday, more rain coming up for them, but it'll be rain, not snow. And then things finally do clear out once again, 46, 49, thing warm-ups on the way for everybody. So that was very sad. So I'm done now. I'm going to send it back to the desk with Nick Carletta, your host for tonight's show.
All right, thanks for that, Tyler. Very sad if every time everyone has to the last one, but we got a nice trivia question, as I mentioned before, to bring up for you guys. So our trivia question here is, if you remember, way back in the day when those of us seniors were still freshmen, we made a big change in size eyes where we had the host, national currents, national weather, and Iowa weather. And now we switched to our current thing where we have weather news and national weather instead. When did this happen? Was that February 4th, 2008? January 28th, September 15th, or February 6th, all in 2008, that was when it happened. One of those you might be able to figure out, because we wouldn't be freshmen anymore. I kind of killed that one. But let's find out what else we got going on here. We're going to take it right over and see what Rachel has for us on the wall.
All right, well, I hope this graphic freaks you out a little bit, but we did have a... This was my favorite moment probably in SciZai's history, Blizzard 2009. We had 14 inches of snow here in Ames. It was as a result of this low-pressure system here. It kind of clipped the southeastern part of the state. As you can see by this arrow, it kind of took this path up south and east, giving us a huge amount of snow, 14 inches in Ames. We had school canceled, so always good news for school to be canceled. Very exciting day. That was my first college snow day and pretty much my only one. We had a half snow day this year, but it wasn't anything like we saw in 2009. And this low pressure system bottomed out at 975 millibars. So it was very deep low pressure system. If you remember here in Ames, I-35 is closed just north of Ames. So they shut those gates that are right beyond the Iowa State exit. That was closer 15 miles north of Ames. We had a 61 mile per hour wind gust with this system, 10 to 15 foot snowdrifts, just huge snowdrifts. Those were in the rural areas surrounding Story County, not quite in Ames, and 8,000 people lost power. So this is my favorite memory of SciZai's, and this is probably my favorite weather event that I've experienced here in Iowa and my time at Iowa State. So a bittersweet memory for me, and I can't believe it's the last time I am on this wall, but I'm gonna send it back to Nick Carletta. So thank you, and I hope that you loved this blizzard as much as I did too.
Oh, thanks for that, Rachel. Rachel, I get sentimental here. We'll be right back with you after this break. Welcome back to our senior show on SciZai's in the Skies. Let's find out what we have for a trivia answer. And this, and as you can see, it was February 6th. It was kind of tricky because those 2 days that are close by were actually practice shows where we tried out a new format. But the first show that went live was February 6th. So let's take it right on over to the wall with Curtis and see what he has for us today.
All right, thanks, Nick. A cooler day today, thanks to the clouds that we saw, but fortunately, those are clearing out of the area right now, and we see about 37 degrees right now. Probably not quite that cool, but winds from the north at 10 miles per hour with a little bit amount of cloudiness. Current conditions across most of the state, we can see partly cloudy down in the Pella, Ames, Waterloo, Storm Lake, and Clarinda area, and a few more clouds over to the east of the state around the Quad City area where the clouds are trying to push out of the area and but still lingering over there just a little bit. So for tonight, we're going to look as the clouds begin to diminish and winds from the north northwest at 4 to 8 miles per hour. And for tomorrow, partly clouds early and then wet and windy as the front begins to move through and the wind shift to be from the southeast, pretty gusty, about 10 to 20 miles per hour. High of 49 tomorrow. Those clouds and rain keeping us a bit cooler than what you would expect to be for this time of year. We're going to look at the extended forecast now for Ames. There we go. Thursday, rain chances, high 49 like I just mentioned. In the Friday, though, cloudy the whole day. It's another chance for us to get a little bit wet, kind of in the regime we've seen lately, lots of rain moving in. But Saturday, partly cloudy with another chance of rain, high 54 as well. And into Sunday and Monday, we can see we're going to get a bit of a warm-up, 60 there on Sunday. And even though we have rain chances, we also expect to reach a high of 62 on Monday. So kind of another rainy forecast in the time to come, but I'm sure we're going to make out of it just fine.
Well, that pattern is awful.
Yes.
But, I mean, at least by, you said by the end of it, though, it looks like it's warming up, so that's
yes.
Really great. Or at least we're going to see, hopefully, by average, again, by the end of the week, mm-hmm. So, or beginning of the week.
Maybe
closer. These April showers will bring great May flowers. Let's
yep.
just hope.
Let's hope for that.
Hope.
We're going to have flowers all over the place with this rain.
I guess
nobody
so.
Hates rain, so that's okay. Yeah. I mean, it's a nice pattern.
I personally want more snow.
And yep. You look a little short.
Well, you did get you.
It's because you're in a different chair.
I'm trying to, like, sit up really straight.
Here at ISU TV, you don't have enough chairs.
You did get your favorite a couple days ago, didn't you? You got some nice thunder snow.
Yes. That was
go.
Exciting.
What? Thursday people, morning.
People don't believe me.
Tuesday morning.
Because they were like, no, it was thunder sleet. And I'm like, no, it was thunder sleet. And then it changed over to snow
there
when
go.
I got on the bus and I heard thunder.
It was a wild morning.
So.
Everybody was complaining about or liking it. Some people liked it. I was sleeping. But.
I love thunder yeah. snow.
I was sleeping too. Didn't see it.
I got
very
up
cold and windy though. Very cold and windy.
I was up right nearly to get that senior breakfast. Got free food.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
I had a nice senior hot pocket for lunch.
Oh, yes. Those very special.
I was stuck waiting at the bus stop for 10 minutes in the sleet, and it was almost like hail. And I was in dress clothes that day because I had to give a presentation.
Same here.
And I was wearing ballet flats, which, if you don't know what those are, essentially, it's just a shoe that doesn't really do anything to keep out water. And I was, my feet were like numb by the time I got on the bus because they were just getting pelted with ice chunks.
It was cold too, obviously.
And it was cold.
Very cold and windy.
So I officially decided that girls have it rough.
We do have it rough. Yes, we do.
We're sleeping. Okay.
Well, I was sleeping. If I would have been outside, I probably would have been miserable because I would have been cold and wet. So.
Cold, wet, windy. That's how it's been. That's how hopefully it won't be for too much longer.
Yeah, let's hope.
I walked to the library that morning, and my feet were soaked, and so I just stole some newspapers and shoved them in there. And by the time I was ready to go, they were pretty dry.
See, well, you see daily scattered everywhere. So yeah. I mean,
that's the kind of that's the kind of thing you learn. See, take a lesson from a senior. Kind of things you learn over your time here at college.
How old? You know, I just thought, we're really old.
Time flies.
I know.
I guess so.
Day ever come. It came.
Well, I know a day.
Today.
Oh, well, maybe we should say that for afterwards. Well, we did prepare a very, very nice slideshow commemorating, our entire duration of being here on Size Eyes in the Sky. So we thought we'd present this slideshow tonight, as it's appropriate, since it's the senior show. So, without further ado, here's the slideshow.
I can't wait to see it.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more. Much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. More, much more than this, I did it my sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. My fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way.
So many memories.
I don't know if our mics were live during that. Yeah. I kind of hope they were.
Yeah. Just in case they weren't live, one thing we want to put in: happy birthday, Nathan Gogo.
Best friend. Happy birthday. He's 20 today.
Oh.
Yeah. 1 year
actually,
closer.
No longer a teenager.
No longer a teenager, but not quite 21.
It's his golden birthday. which is more
special. Oh, that's very special.
Yeah. That's great.
That's exciting. That's really good. That was really kind.
No, one thing, I believe we have two people that were not here and we asked for the favorite size eyes moment. We should have Liz and Chris
bring up favorite size eyes moment.
There's plenty. You can pretty much name any of them.
Jeez.
There's a lot of fun ones.
We want to try Curtis while you think?
Yeah.
Okay, you have
pass
one
the baton.
Off the top
he
of your head.
He has a lot less to think about.
Yeah, I've only been doing this since last semester, but if memory serves me right, and I haven't told anybody here that yet this, the very first time I went on size eyes, on my way here, my pants ripped.
There you go.
If they would have ripped on air, I mean, that would have been
I was nervous enough already, and so the pressure was mounting, but it went okay.
At least you didn't have a clothing malfunction.
Yes.
Yeah.
There you go.
Very
that was
nice.
A fun show.
Really funny. Did you think of one?
Dang.
Did you think of one?
Well,
come back next year, folks.
I kind of have two. Two-ish.
Okay.
I remember, I don't remember what year it was, we did, it was one of our other special ones, we did a special severe weather day with, because there were severe storms going through Ames.
Okay.
And I remember it was one of my first, I think it might have been my freshman year.
We did a lot freshman year with those.
Because it was one of my first experiences with severe weather not being around my family. And that was kind of like when I realized, okay, this is what I want to do. I want to be on TV. I want to be telling people what's going on, what's happening, what they should do, how to help. And that was kind of like, I'd always wanted to do meteorology, but that was like what really sealed the deal. Like, I want to go into broadcast.
Yeah.
And then I guess my other favorite memory, my very first show ever when I was a freshman, I did host, and the camera came live on me, and I just stared at it for about a minute.
I remember that.
Because I started freaking out.
Oh, man.
And I was just like,
what did you do?
Deer in headlights.
And I always tell freshmen who are always really nervous, I'm like, if I could show you my first show, I'm pretty sure you'd have no problems going on air, because it was a complete disaster.
We all remember our first
time.
It
was one of my best memories, so...
Right. Okay. Maybe we should go through and talk about our future plans. Where are we going with our lives? Anyone?
Start on one of the ends.
I'll start.
Okay.
I eventually want to end up in the Northeast, like either one of the northeastern states that gets a lot of the crazy snow.
Nor'easters.
I really want to experience a nor'easter, and you know, seeing a Capitals game at the Verizon Center in DC would be nice too.
There you go.
They're playing right now. I think, I don't know what the score is.
that's also a nice play.
But yeah, so definitely somewhere between D.C. and Maine. Somewhere up in there.
East Coast?
Because it's really pretty up there. East Coast. Apparently that's good for the lungs being near salt water, so added bonus.
Good, very
fun
good.
Fact.
I have cystic fibrosis.
Oh.
So things like that are good for me.
I don't know if that came up in sizes. I came up in sizes before, but
I don't think it ever
first time
has.
For everything.
Better now than never.
Yeah,
obviously.
That's kind of what I plan on doing.
So Mr. Roney?
Well, I'm obviously going to go into broadcast. Where though? I'll take anywhere, to be honest. I don't know where I want to go. I kind of want to stay in the Midwest, but honestly, I'll go anywhere. Maybe I'll bounce around. We'll go to different states, but that's what I want to do, of course. So let's pass it to you.
Okay, well, I'm also going into broadcast. I'm working on my monotone. I know that that's been my downfall for the past couple of years. I hope to stay in the Midwest as I have developed a passion for severe weather over the last probably 2 months. 2 months.
You're gonna say a very short period of time. That's good.
Yeah, I've never seen a tornado, so I hope to see one in the next couple of weeks, or when I start working somewhere, hopefully in the Midwest.
We can't tell my size because
yeah, we'll be right, gone. Yeah. So that's what but I want to see snow. I do like snow, but I want to see severe weather. So somewhere right in the middle, I think that's probably good.
All right. Well, I'm gonna buck the trend here. The reason why I'm host, I'm only in the backstage, so that's why I wasn't on the wall tonight. I'm probably gonna go into somewhere in the operational weather field, so kind of like National Weather Service kind of things. Gonna be going off to your private company in Minneapolis, working for a bit, maybe grad school after that. See where life takes me.
And the finale. Oh, sorry. I apologize.
No, pretty much more the same. I kind of like some of all what you guys have said. I'd like to stay east of the Rockies, but not too far to the east coast, preferably
across the Appalachians.
Yeah, between the mountain ranges, somewhere in the Midwest, either up north or south. Sounds great to me.
I think we're all gonna get jobs based on just that.
I was born and raised here, so I'm like, get out. I want to get out.
do we have any last thank yous or shout outs. Thank yous and shout outs.
It's been a good run. Yeah. It really has. And I want to thank Matt Hoffman for making me do this.
Especially.
Because I think it's been the most positive thing in my life.
What a motivator. He really was. Jeff Edmondson as well. I can speak for that.
Yeah, Gertz that made me do it.
Oh, well.
So,
one person.
Good shout out to him as well.
Person we really need to bring up is Scott Lincoln. He played a huge role back in freshman year. This show would have fallen apart many times.
We still ask him about the graphics machine.
All the time. Yeah, then, of course, even going back to all of our old producers, we had Justin Schultz, Jason Patton, Ben McNeil, Jeff Evanson, Andy Mayer, Ryan Ellis, and this year, David Corbelly and Rachel Witter, all of our producers.
Great job. Everybody has its work here, whether you're on air, backstage, it doesn't matter. We're a big family, so it's kind of sad to see us go.
Yeah, I think with that, can we just have a group hug? Can we get on camera six?
Oh,
we're going to have a group hug.
I'm going to take the mic off or I'll get tingled.
Yo,
bye, everybody. Oh, this is it. Hold on.
We should go right there. 1, 2, 3.